You'll begin seeing exactly what I mean. But for the time being, yeah.
It's the key version of, like, blood magic, where it's like, oh, it's like kind of supernatural, intertwined in the universe thing, but it's not magic, per se.
It's preternatural, not supernatural.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you guys could explore it. Which I guess, actually, now that I think about it, this is actually, I was going to bring it up earlier, but I forgot. Yeah, Dorky is doing fine. She did finally mention to be back about yesterday at 7 o'clock.
Uh-huh.
She's doing fine, and she hopes to be back soon.
TM.
Her dissertation got given an extension. Da-da-da-da-da.
Mm-hmm.
So, obviously this is sort of an out-of-game or in-game explanation for why she's absent out of game and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So, at a certain point, her symptoms will alleviate whenever she comes back. But in-game, it's a hard ask. Out-of-game, it's an impossible ask. So, there you go. But yeah, it definitely is. So I will say, like, that's not to dissuade you guys from pursuing the avenue in game as characters, because it definitely are. Because even, okay, here's the thing: even when Dorky comes back, that shit still will be there. I'm not. Oh, the magic that goes away. No, shit's still gonna be there. So, like, yeah, you're afraid of exploring again.
Okay. Yeah, and that's why I wanted to ask now. I didn't expect there to be a solution right away or anything. Obviously. Yeah.
Surely there is. Okay. Quote unquote, surely there is, but it's a question of, like, where do you even begin asking that?
Right? Like, our best bet right now is probably Skavul, and he's given us about as much as we'll probably get.
I don't think it takes an insight check to realize that she probably does know more on it. She just doesn't give a shit enough to tell you.
Huh? Exactly.
A lovely pair.
Either because she doesn't think you guys need to know it, or she doesn't want you guys to know it. One or the other. She's like, sets her information for your quote-unquote benefit.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah. That seems to placate Zal enough, so you guys are sort of left to chill for a little bit, as you guys are... Well, Blair immediately begins cooking stuff.
Nice.
I was about to say, it's, if no one else does, Silas will go help whoever wants to cook, so...
It's Blair. It's 100% Blair. You guys won't be able... You guys will actually have to fight her in order to take that right from her.
I feel like Silas is a little bit more competent in the kitchen, so they could help a bit more.
What was... Someone requested, like, a certain dish last session.
Yes, it was I think it was fish or something like that?
Yeah.
Oh,
okay.
Oh, yeah. Now that you mention it.
And then Blair muttered to herself, I think I still know that recipe.
I didn't write down what the recipe was, but I wrote down...
No, she definitely did not say the recipe. She definitely did not say the recipe. She basically ends up making the equivalencies of, like, fish tacos.
Hey.
Nice. Oh, okay.
Tacos. Nice.
Yeah, so fish tacos or fish and chips... it's the same sort of beer batter sort of thing. It's really good. It's really hearty. It has a lot of caloric intake, by the way, with a lot of, like, sauce and stuff. Anyways, moving on.
I'm getting hungry now.
After about, like, an hour, like, you guys are, like, basically, about, like, setting in to eat and stuff like that, and no, Boyer will not accept any compliments or she'll punch you. Tolus and Dove come back.
Nice.
How that? No. All of you make me inside jokes.
Alright.
Can I have advantage that's fueled by fatherly worry?
Hmm? Holding hands and getting each other pregnant?
Yeah, sure.
Pregnant,
do you mean?
Pregnant.
Pregnant,
yep. Yeah.
Holy God.
Kirsty, you and I rolled the exact same thing.
Oh my God!
Yeah, that's surprising. Double took lessons with Silas on lying.
Honestly, I need to get this boy deception proficiency. He's had to lie so much.
I mean, he gets it just from, like,
from this. Had to lie so much. Every time I make the fucking check for Tolus, then fucking hell, dude. I'll just link to our old sheet. So, new sheet. Tolus. Insighto. Alright, so moving on. Damn. So everyone succeeds from the looks of it. Delvet.
I sure hope so.
Delvet is. How to say? I'm trying to think of, like, an analogy for how to describe it. He's forlorn. He looks like a man on the way to the execution row. And he's doing his very best to try to hide it, but he's not doing well at it. And Tola's cat, like, catches this fucking handily. You all catch it. But the thing is, Tola's, while she does catch it, she doesn't interrogate him on it. She just tries to maintain talking with him normally. Almost like trying to set up this sense of comfort and familiarity.
Does it seem like it's coming, like, is something happened with Tolos on the way back, or is it from something that happened when he was with the Seekers?
To all of you butts ajar, sorry. Probably at the Seekers.
Yeah.
No, Tolos didn't give him a death threat on the way back.
I mean, I was thinking more like, I don't know, she said something that broke his heart or something. I don't know.
Poor guy.
No,
yeah, you're kind of weird looking.
Yeah, no, it's more like, these are such good roles. Whatever diagnosis he got from Rickard was not a good one.
Oh.
It's like someone getting told you now have terminal cancer.
Oh.
Right. Which for him is probably, hey, you get whatever is benefiting you temporarily, but it's gonna wear off. But my best guess would be.
I will say, to Oriana with that 28 and to Alessandra with that nat 20. Actually, you broke into 25 as well. Man, you guys all did so well.
Honestly.
Okay, because so many of you guys got 25 and above, it definitely was a bad prognosis. But also, it might be Delvet playing in his own head a bit too much.
Right. Like, it's not as bad as it is, but he's, like, constantly thinking about it.
It's not good.
It could get worse.
Yeah. Exactly. It's not good, but he's definitely catastrophizing it. Where he's been given a range of not good things, and he's jumping to the worst of them, of the end of the spectrum. But he is maintaining some face, shittily, but he's trying at the very least. And Tola's talking to him does help with that to a certain degree. Blair doesn't know how to help except through threats of violence.
Hey, goes.
Oh no, she doesn't hold the work on that one, but she does get guidance. So 24.
Say 5 next to the layman.
That's a charges they have when she draws it on the field. It has a number of uses equal to spellcasting mod, so it always starts at 5 because it's not getting any higher. But at 24, as you know. As you guys give Tolos and Delva the same treatment of a shut-in at a family gathering, like, well, look who finally came down for dinner treatment, except more, more inquisitively, Blair just says, about fucking time, sit down and eat, or else. False sense of comfort, false sense of threat. Sort of comforting in a way. The two of them sit down and eat.
Well, good to see you, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I guess you could say that.
Alessandro with his hands still, like, interlocked in front of him is like, well, what would you say?
Yes, but would you say that?
Did I actually say that?
Yeah.
Alright, so we're doubling down angry dad roll. Gotcha. Roll intimidation.
Ooh.
First you hit him, now you're intimidating him.
I wasn't going for that, but yeah, sure, I guess we are.
Oh my god, for Velvet, Jesus.
Oh, damn, he got better than Blair. I...
No, stop. Just eat for now. I'll talk about it later.
Right. Tolos low-key looks like she's ready to cry. You guys sit down to a quiet supper.
It's just dead silent.
Oh, yeah, my bad. School, I did disappear after the Dietz diagnosis.
Damn it.
I mean, she's always around for you. I mean, it's like to everyone else visibly, she disappeared.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, you guys eat in rather tense silence. Zol does Zol things, and he's, like, eating this, like, fish and chips. So, how's y'all's day? Anything cool happen? Any people we gotta beat the shit out of, or?
God, a lot.
Did you put the shit beat out of him? Sort of.
Yes, let's focus on that one, actually.
Oh, was there?
Is that why you were sweating?
I, for the record, I don't stink. That's not me.
And so you stink. That is a confession that you went to. I just said you smelled like sweat.
I come from a desert climate. I don't sweat easily. No.
That's a point of pride, that he doesn't sweat easily. That's a point of pride!
Do you want to go take a bath? Would that make you feel better?
Prestidigitation. Done. Can we stop talking about this now?
Alright,
regardless, who did you fight?
Forgot to ask the name, to be honest.
Oh, shoot, yeah, none of us did. Alright, yeah. What's she was it? Good with her blade, though.
Very skilled, in fact. Far beyond my capabilities.
Blair slams her fist into the table. Fuck!
Okay.
Hmm?
You good there, Blair?
What's good? What?
Forgot to ask Roderick.
I mean, I doubt he's asleep right now.
I was gonna ask who that person was. No, it's fine. They just seem so familiar to me. It's fine. She goes back to eating. And she is eating at the table with you guys right now.
Yay! Who's she sitting beside? It's improvement!
You? Fucking... I feel like you're fishing for compliments on that one, because we already know.
No, I didn't! Fuck you!
Fuck you! She's not sitting next to you anymore. Just do the dishes.
Well, fuck!
But to answer your question, I was able to go full out, hold nothing back, and I got soundly defeated. I wouldn't say beaten, because obviously I'm not in pain or anything like that. And they asked me very pointed questions that aren't necessarily comfortable to face, especially when they're asked in that context, in that circumstance. And I've come to realize a few things. I need to be more honest with myself to start with.
Very enlightening fight.
Would you say it was a positive outcome then?
I would.
Can you describe this person? I'm rather familiar with a lot of slayers. They come through my hometown to train all the time.
And if she could keep up with you, then it sounds like she's not exactly a pushover.
More than keep up, surpassing easily.
Can you describe
her?
Yes, I describe her to the best of my ability.
There are certain things which are like, that doesn't really help. It's like her gear, her attire, like the type of gear it is, but when you describe that, it's like a bit more ornate, a bit more flowy. Her nature, her disposition. Abigail begins nodding.
She did this really cool maneuver with daggers that, with radiance, and it was impressive. I was pincushioned. It was painful.
Ooh. Slayer Captain Annika. Annika Renau. She looks at Blair. That's why she's so familiar to you. You two are the first and second youngest captains amongst the Slayers. Blair just sort of looks at Abigail for that, like, not like annoyed or anything, they're just sort of, like, just thinking.
The information that's been presented.
Yeah.
Was the Memento Mori thing that, I don't know if it's a moment, the thing that Orion was given in relation
it's called the Memento Mori, yeah.
It is that one, okay. It has like an image that has Blair along with like a bunch of like Slayers and Secret Captains,
yep.
Right?
Yep.
Could she just kind of pop that out and see if that person is there?
Oh, hey, it's right next to Blair.
Oh, hey.
Well, that would have been kind of easier, actually, if I... Yeah. Abigail remember though.
Yes, huh. I see. Monica. This is so important for the captain. The Blade of Grace. That's what it was. Varric right next to her nods approving, like, very good, Blade of Grace, very good.
Understand, they talk about.
As a fellow Blade of Grace. How do you do, fellow Blades of Grace?
Grace of gods or grace and dexterous capabilities? Or both?
Why mutually exclusive? They could be one in union.
All the best monikers have double meanings.
Hmm.
To answer your question simply, Oriana, both. She is renowned to be immensely fast on the field. Obviously, she carries a divinity about her. I also have it on good word of mouth that she is rather. She thinks I had to say it. She like awkwardly like shakes her head left and right, thinking rather. She just sighs and gives up. Rather cruel on the field to her opponents.
Now that sort of grin that you, that makes more sense now.
If it was my understanding that between you and her, Blair, you two were the most scariest ones on the field at times. You for divine might, her for divine grace mixed with cruelty. Blair just sort of sits on that information. She doesn't really know how to, what to do with it, really. Like she processes it. She understands it, but it's like, eh. It's like, be like, your dad used to be a lacrosse champion back in middle school. Like all right, there's so cool. Many things of that I don't care about. Because it's not relevant to me right now.
Cool. Good right, good for him. He's well.
Cool story, bro.
Right, I'm going to have to run off cool as well, because I was getting quite close to midnight for.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you're not going to be able to talk to Chath and Bellamy.
I know! Oh, it's 11, and I was like, shit! It's fine. Just, yeah, it's fine.
We could save it for next sesh, because I feel like that's very important.
I'm fine with that.
Mm-hmm.
If it helps at all, Oriana wants to talk to Scavola, so we could probably find something else that everyone else wants to talk to as well. As well as we have to figure out where the few is, anyway, so we could...
Oh, do you guys actually bring it up?
A certain number of people saw the few note.
Oh, yeah, sorry. Yeah, I'm just good.
Yeah, you're good.
Yeah, we'd bring it up. Yeah. No, we're gonna keep it secret. We're gonna an exclusive club. On our own.
I don't know.
And Anishka's gonna have her little, oh my god, it was her moment in secret. And then she's going to cry.
You peaked your mic, good job. when you guys bring it up, like, Zal just remarks the few. Oh! Wait.
Is that where you got drugs?
No! Not even that. Dude's random about the drug. Roll insight.
Can I also roll insight?
Yeah, go ahead.
Is that the drugs?
Okay, also, Kirsty, if you want to hop on, be my guest.
Yep, okay, cool. See you later. Don't worry about like
next
just
week.
It,
next week, normal start? Question mark. Points gun
yes,
at you.
Normal start. Yes. You can put the gun away. We're good.
Never.
What?
Never.
Damn it. Run. Okay, I'll see you later.
Thank
bye.
You.
Good night.
Bye.
Kind of suspicious. She wants to put her guns away.
Yeah.
So un-American of
us. Just like the British put their guns away with their freedom along with it. Anyways, so 22 and 23, that he actually is telling the truth.
Oh shit.
Not over that dude related drugs, alright? I was like one time. Okay. Make it sound like it's a character defining trait of me all of a sudden.
That's my bad.
That's
I made an assumption. I'm sorry about that.
Regardless.
Boss like wags like a piece of like deep fried fish at him. He's just like, yeah, but you also did punch. Like, he doesn't say anything, but he's just like, yeah, but he also did sort of punch me, so so he's just like, anyways.
What did you think of Zal?
We heard me and Deer walk around, we heard people saying stuff like that. And I had no fucking clue what they were talking about. But we did pass by tavern and inn, whatever, out in the Hunter's District Court. The Hunter area, north of town.
Hunter's Quarters.
Called the Hunter's Quarters. There you go. Whatever. And it's just called Fire, Earth, and Wind. And I was like, that's a shit fucking name. But now if you're saying like that, I think people just call it The Few.
That would make sense.
Which is a way better fucking name than Fire, Earth, and Wind. It's not even a the in the beginning. It's not even like a qualifier at the end of that. It's like, come on, I ain't going to eat Fire, Earth, and Wind. Like, come on.
Why not? A lot of experience with Storm, Earth, and Fire.
I have a lot of experience with inns. Thank you very much.
Go up fair.
All the best ones got those certain things about, not this fucking abstract Fire, Earth, and Wind.
There it is. I was wondering who's gonna post it.
All right, I was wondering who was gonna post it first. You take a D inspiration, Patty. And...
Shame.
It wasn't me.
It wasn't you. Don't worry, I'm not actually giving you a Patty. I knew I was getting into.
Cool name though.
You the original name of the map is even funnier.
Oh.
Won't tell it to you because then it's gonna be memeified. Then it's be yeah.
That's just Earth, Wind, and Fire.
No,
What if I promise? What if I promise?
Do you promise? You swear? Thrice?
I do.
Your name and power?
On your name. Mm-hmm. Your true name.
On your name?
I, Winter, swear that I won't meme on the name of, what did you say, the map?
You have to swear thrice. Say it thrice.
Do I have to? Three times?
You can just say you swear thrice.
I swear thrice.
Alright. Then here you go. That's the name of it. I got rid of that's actually a deletable thing on the bottom right there.
Okay.
Oh, only she gets to see?
I didn't hear others swearing!
I triple swear. My name is Alec.
Alright, someday.
I wanna know, sure, yeah. Actually, it would genuinely be like me or me not. That would be the problem children about this, isn't it?
Oh.
I'm not gonna make fun of it.
Right?
I got that one joke last night. I'm good. Last night? The night before? With Basso?
Oh, the dragon deeds?
Yeah.
Yeah, don't worry. He's always gonna make that joke as soon as Vasu gets around to that shit. It's way funny as fuck.
I got that one joke. I won't meme on this one. Can I see it, please?
I hear the magic words, literally.
Sure. I can't say words. I swear it thrice.
Upon your name.
Yes, upon my name is Daniel Patrick Kelly.
I'll send it for free, though.
I could dox it.
I'll send it for free.
Fred isn't a problem child.
Fred isn't a problem child. Honestly, you probably have heard worse in like probably heard the same or worse in WoW. I mean, honestly, like, I'm pretty sure there's some joke names in there for the ends.
Yeah, Goldshire.
Can confirm.
Yeah. So that's the end. The clock and button is kind of the Fire from Wind. So Zol / D, but really Zol heard of it. It's in the Hunter's district. Technically, the Hunter's, God damn, I need that map back. It wasn't Corden. Maybe it was Corden. I need the fucking map back. No clue where it went.
What did you do with it?
I don't know.
Oh. You're always misplacing your maps everywhere.
Oh, Burrow. Hunter's and Trapper's Burrow.
Oh, that makes sense.
Better.
The problem is that map's not accurate. Anyways, he doesn't know exactly where it is, but it wouldn't be too hard to. It's very commonly known. You guys could just ask people where it is.
Yeah, at least now we know what to look for or ask for.
Yeah, just ask like a common drunkard. Be like, hey, do you know this place? It's like, oh yeah, it's right over there.
So
literally behind us.
So we know where the place is, more or less. We know the time.
Uh huh.
He looks at Sajar. Should we set something up? Talking about trapping Deed's brother. Why not trap this?
Yes, a good idea.
Here's a counterpoint. If they're
I don't know if that'd be wise.
If they're setting up the location, they probably already have it trapped, or they're already watching it.
Agreed. It seems like trying to outthink the thinker on this would just get us into more trouble. I'm not a fan of walking into a trap.
I forget exactly what his message was.
Let me see. I wrote it down.
Looks at Nexus Link name.
I know.
Tomorrow morning, meet me at the Few. That's it.
Oh, no. Which message? Sorry, the original message or the sending message?
I should have specified the sending.
Ooh.
looks at Nexus like that.
Yeah, I know. I don't know how far to scroll up, though.
It's right around... I think I pinned the NPCs as goals. Click on that, and then it's really right above it.
Let me see here. I mean, this is just something I can just say. I feel like Silas would come to the conclusion of, like, this is probably going to be at least partially about their parents. And they'd voice that they're like, I don't know if that's a good idea. If this has anything to do with my family, I don't want the conversation starting on the wrong foot.
I found it. It has reached my ears that your band is no longer in the north, that you depart for more fruitful and wise endeavors, such withdrawals are to be rewarded, and I would like to parlay with all of you for such. Pick a place within your realms of access, and I shall meet you there. You guys said Duvros, and now this is the meeting. Mm-hmm. Their part.
So yeah, so that's what, I said.
Yeah.
Look, there's no way the situation can be totally in our favor. We're just gonna have to deal with discomfort.
Whatever hand we're played.
Effectively.
Captain Bellamy had the opportunity to slaughter us back at the north, but chose not to.
They did.
And she stops for a second, thinking reminiscently. Slaughter me and others before you guys even left Lyco's trial. I understand that they are a snake, but we have to walk into their grasp with this, no matter what, anyways.
Yes.
At least at a bar.
And if you really don't want to, if you really want to, you can not be involved in the conversation and just keep watch for us.
Honestly, I'm a bit concerned about people here.
Yeah, if you want to say yeah, that we don't need everyone to be there.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but Alessandra, you did not receive a message.
I did not. I don't know this person.
And they don't know you. Do you want to keep it that way?
I cannot say for certain if they don't know me. For all we know, they've been watching us ever since we entered Duvros. But I would like to take precautions, yes.
If you want, Tolis undoes a part of their hood, the slasher cow, and slides it over to you.
What is it?
Cow of Disguise.
Oh.
Which I totally forgot Tolis had for a little bit, not gonna lie, but when I checked the budget, she purchased it, so.
Ooh.
I guess she just hasn't, honestly, she probably just hasn't had a need to use it this whole time, so, makes sense. So you can take that and you had to tune to it, I think. It's based on how to disguise. I think you need to tune to it, but other than that, you just cast a set itself for yourself.
I'm pretty sure.
I don't recall the item 100% off the top of my head.
Yeah, if it's one for one of how to disguise just the cowl, then let me requires attunement.
Okay, there you go. Yeah, I mean, so out of game, it's up to you guys who you guys want to bring, because everyone isn't exactly how to say. Everyone realizes this is a very slippery scenario, and they both simultaneously want to go to back you, but also don't want to go because this shit seems like a trap. So why put all the fucking eggs in one basket? So it's up to you guys who you guys want to take. I imagine all the PCs, like just as starting baseline, right? Here, I actually pure sort of this.
Yeah, you'll get Amber.
Yeah, that's funny. No deep. The size differences on this really bug me.
Yeah, I was gonna say it looks really out of line.
Don't worry about it. Just don't worry about it.
I'm not worrying.
I don't care enough.
You're freaking out.
I am.
You're breathing manually.
That doesn't bug me. Try again.
I'll say Zol will stay behind.
You're like, pissing manually.
That one's automatically out.
Garth. You piss automatically?
You guys don't get Barak. Sorry, he doesn't know you guys at all.
That's fair. You know what?
He wouldn't become anyway. I don't even care.
Also, I lined this up perfectly. Look at this. The line from this tower goes to the line of his token. I just caught my eye right now. I was like, oh, hey.
And then this half just kind of falls off and goes down here. That just falls into the little thing. Tink. Okay, so Varric's not going. He's staying over there.
Honestly, I sort of want to do this. She's like, you're not fucking getting away, bitch.
You know what? Yeah.
Fair enough.
I mean, okay, Abigail still wants to talk with Varric, and he still wants to talk with all of you, so... Like, that might change that entirely. Like, if you, like... Like, I will say Varric 100% carries himself with confidence. He doesn't promote it or advocate for it, but there's a quiet confidence there, so... He ain't afraid of backing you guys.
Well...
How about this? Who... Orianna voices it of, who amongst you want to go? I imagine they all have their own thought process on it. I also want to incorporate Blair into the conversation, as well as the rest of the NPCs.
I'm not a fan of it. I don't think any of us are. How much can we trust a chaplain to Multiface Seshub? I'll go. Tullus holds up her hand. Marika and Vasa look at each other like, we're really gonna let that slide.
Yeah, everyone's like looking around like, who's gonna tell her? Who's gonna tell her she can't come?
To be fair, they might actually be capable in this case.
I'll go. Devil holds up his hand.
Got back his cool.
I don't forbid it.
It's not a case of backing his girl, no.
Well, if I am going regardless of who else is going, so there's that.
I'm going as well.
Anushka wants to go. Don't fucking question shut up.
So why go? Okay.
I want to go.
As Zol was saying, we shouldn't all go. Some people should stay here for Isadora and Diet and Hafnin.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Which, by the way,
if you want me here, I can stay here. Your choice.
I mean, he looks at Merrick. Vasa looks at Merrick. You've been taking care of him all day, right? She nods. He looks at you guys. It seems like more of a reason to find a reason to change that, right? It seems more of a pain.
Hmm.
Then I'll stay, but she looks at Tullus. Be careful. She nods. Two NPCs staying, two NPCs going so far, so it's pretty even.
Yep.
Vasa doesn't like it. Go on.
These are the three we have to stick with? Just to pick from?
Yeah, it's sort of up to you. I mean, Blair doesn't really know any context here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. She has no fucking clue what all this is about. I think Kasai would want to go, because this is on matters of Norvid peace, so... Sorry, Robin, your choice.
No, that's 100%... That's why I presented it as an option. Or, presented it to them. I was like, do they have a passion for it? Alright, cool.
Also, let me know that the people staying here also have Celine, so...
Blair can hang out with Flower.
She doesn't fucking... She barely tolerates that flower, so she doesn't trust it.
Okay, so we have Blair who has really next to no context. If we provide context, yeah. I don't know if that would change her mind.
I mean, she honestly still wants to keep working on shit, but she'll back you guys, wherever you guys pick.
I don't think she has a horse in this race, so she can busy herself with that.
I think that's a fair call.
Okay, so basically, abstain.
Mm-hmm.
I think with her these two, but we'll get there when we get there.
We'll get there! Yeah, then. I would almost want Vasa to come along just so at least one of the two, like, tallest parental figures is there so that they can, like, chill.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Trust us with your child. It's like, only as long as one of us is there. It's like, that's not what I'm saying, but okay. Oh, he's gone. Oh, he's back.
Put his cool helmet on.
Gotta get my hat.
Yeah, so that's more or less the allocation. But then you guys do arrive at, you know, Abigail and Varric. I must be honest, I have little context of this force similar to...